Summer learning is something that's beneficial for all students, but necessary for some. And over a century's worth of research shows us that kids fall behind during the summer. But this effect disproportionately affects low-income young people. And research shows that by ninth grade, over half of the achievement gap in reading can be attributed to unequal access to summer learning. And this discrepancy is often not visible to us while it happens, but it takes place year after year, and it affects large populations of students across the Commonwealth, undermining school fundamentals. Fortunately, the solution is as exciting as the problem is daunting, and this bill builds on a proven approach to get results in both academics and skills. First, the bill's requirement of at least 150 hours of programming is based on national research in five cities, including Boston, covering 5,000 students. The two reports show solid evidence that this approach works.
Summer learning matters. Those who don't get it slide backwards. Those who do get it advance, and this happens 12 times during the K-12 sequence, and the gaps get larger and larger. So it has always been my conviction when I was in office with Governor Patrick and as an advocate that summer ought no longer to be an accident of birth that favors those with privilege and disadvantages those without. It really ought to be an entitlement. So I wrote a piece in a national publication here called Summer Learning as the Third Semester. We ought to recognize this is an entitlement, as invisible as it may be to those of us who take it for granted. It isn't invisible for those deprived of the opportunity. And if we know, then we have the research evidence to underline the importance of summer learning, then we ought to be taking action as quickly as we can, given the limitations of resources, to make this available and to prioritize children in greatest need.